take a low-dose aspirin to prevent heart attack or stroke. For years, that's what millions of Americans have been told. But new preliminary guidance says that older Americans without heart disease should not start taking an aspirin a day. The panel of experts from the U.S. Preventative Service Task Force says taking an aspirin a day may cut the risk of heart disease and strokes for some adults older than 60, but for others, it could raise the risk of internal bleeding and do more harm than good. The task force also offering guidance for people ages 40 to 59, those who are at risk or a higher risk of heart disease. Experts say they should talk to their doctors before taking aspirin daily. Heart disease is the leading cause of death in America, according to the CDC. It kills more than 650,000 people each year. That's one person every 36 seconds. Dr. Harlan Krumholtz is with us now, a cardiologist and scientist at Yale University. Doctor, thanks so much. Many Americans have been taking a daily low-dose aspirin for years. Should they stop?
Well, you know, we always recommend that people should talk to their doctor before they do anything with their medications. But it's important to realize that this is draft guidance. And as you said, it's about people who are prone to heart disease, not people who have heart disease. There still remain many situations where we're really confident that aspirin provides a service to people. But these experts are coming together with this draft guidance. It's out for public comment at this point, recommending, based on their interpretation of the evidence, that people on low-dose aspirin may not be getting a benefit if they're taking it to prevent heart disease in the future, even if they're prone to heart disease.
Yeah, just a recommendation, as you rightly mentioned so far. But do you see this becoming the new rule?
Well, this group of experts has carefully studied the literature, the medical research. And over the last few years, the research has started to point us away from the value of low-dose aspirin in people prone to heart disease, again, people without heart disease. And I'm fairly confident that a lot of these recommendations, the recommendations that aspirin may not be as useful for older people, and for those in middle age, it's a bit of a toss-up, and they ought to be talking to their doctors about it. I'm fairly confident that'll be the final recommendations.
Interesting. Doctor, the task force also released new guidance on diabetes screenings. They advise that adults who are obese or even overweight should start getting tested for diabetes at an earlier age. The previous recommendation was 40. Now it's 35-year-olds. Doctor, how important is this change?
Yeah, I think it's a very important change. Look, for people who are overweight or more, diabetes is something that's always lurking. It's a risk. And we want to be able to help people to reach more ideal weights and to be able to prevent diabetes. But we know many people are overweight. And this is in recognition of that and is telling us that even starting at 35, we're starting to see higher rates of diabetes, and we ought to be looking for it so we can help people with recommendations, guidance, and see if we can mitigate the potential harms.
Before we go, what is the most important thing that those of us who are a little older need to do every day to generally stay more healthy?
Yeah, I think keeping physically active is critically important. And I'd also say know your blood pressure, getting your blood pressure under control, making sure it's not elevated. Even at older ages, there's value in that. But keeping active, there's no doubt about it. That's the best thing you can do for yourself.
Doctor, thanks so much.